Martin, I seem to recall several years ago, and I guess Dano's 1283 came up. You said, never going to get there, you know. And now you still got a ways to get there, but you're going to hit 1,200. Well, what does that mean?
Oh, I don't know. You know, I think it's been a great ride. I think I was fortunate to play a lot of games. You know, as a goalie, you know, it's kind of hard to get to these numbers. You know, wins and all that, it's one thing, but to be durable and be able to play, you know, for so long, and the organization trusts you to be in between their pipes for them for that long, I guess it means a lot. You know, I think, you know, I like to play games, and, you know, if you look at the numbers, it means I played a lot.
And the Devils like to put you in there, obviously. But not just for a goalie, obviously the only goalie who will get to 1,200, but less than 100 in the NHL have done it too. So it's not easy for anyone.
Yeah, you know, there's so many things. I think you need to be at a certain level to be able to play for that long in the NHL. You know, it's not an easy league to be part of. And I think, you know, I was fortunate to be on a team, like we said earlier, that believed in me and wanted me in there.
But at this stage, you're playing as well as you have at many times in your career. Is that maybe the most gratifying part of reaching 1,200?
Well, you know, I think you have games that you feel good. You know, other games, it's a little harder. I think you get to a certain age, I think you just appreciate the game a little more because, you know, there's not many left, and so you just want to go out and try to perform. And, you know, I work hard, and I want to make sure I'm ready when I'm called upon to play these games. And, you know, it's a great atmosphere in this locker room for the last 2 years with the success we had last year. And starting this year, you know, having similar faces around also. And I think it helps me to be successful to a certain extent, because knowing what to expect every night when you get in there.
Have you and Johan together, now you're together, have the team top five in goals against, and neither of you have played competitive hockey during the lockout. Has this been a pleasant surprise to you as well, the way you guys have performed as a tandem?
Well, you know, we expected it, I guess, to a certain extent. You know, I think we all have a lot of pride, and then we know that we were scrutinized a little bit because of our age coming out of a long layoff that we had, you know, because of the lockout. So we prepared ourselves real well to get to this point, and we just got to continue. You know, our job is not to win every single, you know, hockey game. Is to give our team a chance to win, and I think, you know, so far, me and Eddie's been doing that, and we got to keep doing that. You know, we're the type of team that we're not going to score, you know, 5-6 goals a game, so definitely we need to make the big saves. You know, we're playing well defensively. We just, you know, try to make the save that are important.
Today, this weekend, you get two cracks at the only team that you have not earned a point against that you've played. You feel the antenna is up in the room for this home-and-home series?
Yeah, you know, the guys are real focused, you know, and I think it said a lot about our team last night, because it would have been easy to kind of, you know, look over Tampa, even though they're a good team, knowing that, you know, we just played the Rangers and we have a great matchup back-to-back game against Pittsburgh. But we came through and played well, and we played a team that's similar as far as the way they play, as offensively with their speed. And we fared pretty well yet last night, so I think we're going to take that and try to build on that and hopefully, you know, play well against Pittsburgh. It's always been a tough team to play against because of the, you know, the high skill level they have.
Did you see Eliash's goal celebration last night?
Yeah.
Was it better than Yakupov's?
It shows his maturity.
You've been through so much. Is there a wake-up call? I don't know if that's the right term, but what was last Saturday's game against Pittsburgh like, and what has it done? Because the team's bounced back nicely from it.
Well, you know what? We didn't play well, and we were in the game going into the third period. We had, I think, three chances to tie up the game early in the third, and after that, you know, it went south on us. And you know what? Through the season, games will happen like that, you know, and they're a good hockey team. They're a team that were looking for themselves a little bit at that time. You know, they just lost against the Islanders. They haven't won a game in their own building. So you know that they were going to push it, and they did, and we had a hard time, you know, handling it, and hopefully we've learned from it. You know, I think our game is to be, you know, a patient game, and especially when you play a high-power offense team, you know, you just can't trade chances.
It's exciting. A little two-game, you know, almost measuring stick against top two teams in the East.
Yeah, try to get through the snowstorm first, and we'll get excited tomorrow. Hopefully there'll be a game. Hopefully there'll be people watching the game. Listening to the game. Sorry, man. I think you have a better bet listening to the game. it's a great challenge. And again, and that's what a shortened season will bring is, you know, it's 4 points one way or the other. It's going to swing pretty hard. And, you know, for us to get back close to them or past them or them, you know, taking a good step in front of us. So there's a lot at stakes, you know, so it's going to be a good matchup.